The humans have made great strides in space flight and the space explorations in the relatively short amount of time since such feats were first accomplished. Human beings always have keen interest of discovering of life in dark places of universe behind the bright stars. That is why NASA and the other space agencies have been launching the space telescope to find the bright side of life in the other places of the exoplanets in and around other galaxies and in our own galaxy. Those are billions of light years away from home. To find life, NASA launched some space telescopes like Kepler, Spitzer, Hubble, and recently the James Webb Space Telescope. Hello everyone. In this topic, I would like to build the brief differences or working differences of the Kepler and the James Webb Space Telescope. Now the Kepler. The Kepler was launched in 2009. It was specifically designed to survey our region of Milky Way galaxy to discover hundreds of Earth size and the small planets in and near the habitable zone and determine the fractions of the hundreds of billions of stars in our galaxy that might have such planets. Kepler seeks to answer these questions by staring at a small region of sky containing more than 1 lakh stars for 3.5 years and thus determine what fraction of stars have terrestrial planets. In answering this question, Kepler have generated several data of confirmed transiting planets together with the sum of the other basic properties and composition of their atmosphere. Kepler is out of work, Kepler is out of fuel, so Kepler is retired now. Now the James Webb. The James Webb mission is much larger than the Kepler's. The James Webb main mission is to understand how the early galaxies formed and grew. But along with this objective, it has another objective, and that is to detect the possible chemical signatures of life on other planets. But there is a big difference between the Kepler's and the Webb's working principles. The Kepler is designed to be a wide and the shallow survey telescope, while Webb is designed for narrow and the deep focus studies with near and the mid-infrared imaging and the spectroscopy. How the Webb will going to detect the life, that is the main question. If the life exists outside of Earth, it will release the distinct chemical signatures such as the breathing carbon dioxide and photosynthesizing out oxygen that can transform a planet. Analyzing the chemicals in a planet's atmosphere will not only allow the scientists to look for life, but also enable them to assess a planet's habitability. And Webb can detect infrared wavelengths for fingerprinting chemicals such as the water and the methane presence in the atmosphere of exoplanets, which are the planets beyond of our solar system, billions of light years away. The Webb contains the instruments that will allow the scientists to unravel the wavelengths of the infrared signal from solar system beyond ours, to unweave the colors of the infrared rainbow. When an exoplanet photobombs a star that our telescopes are gazing at, the straight light will experience a dip in certain energies corresponding to the chemicals in the exoplanet's atmosphere. If the Webb happens to be looking at the right star at the right time, it will chemically analyze the atmosphere of the star's planet by analyzing the blip in the straight light. The Webb will going to complement the work of the Kepler as well as the Hubble. Every telescope discovery is always an opening path for the next and the bigger versatile telescope. No one is bigger than no one. Everyone is equal. That is science. So, since the discovery of the first exoplanets of the 1992 begins, the human beings fall in love with the exoplanets and the planets in and around the other solar systems. From these differences, from there, the different kind of exoplanet like the gas giants, hot super Earth and the ice giants always broke the shackles of the human imaginations. So the science is all about greater discovery. More you look, more you see, more you discover. That is science. Now we have reached our questions part. And today's question is, first scientific detections of the exoplanets discovery started in which year? First option is 1976, second is 1980, third is 1984, fourth is 1988, fifth is 1990. And now the question related to the UPSC exam, Union Public Service Commission exam. The question is, how discovery of life on any exoplanet will going to change the definitions of life on Earth in the eyes of the human being? If you wants to write me the answer, please write me the answer to my email address that I have already gave to you. And that email address is tuhin.power.academy@gmail.com. Thank you very much. Thank you for listening.